Good morning, students. Welcome back to my 21st lecture of your subject code C701, module 6. We are discussing in the last 20th lecture, that is the water distribution. And one simple problem we just solved, that is Hardy-Cross method. And some more complicated network problem today I will discuss on that Hardy-Cross method, that is the analysis of the pipe network distribution systems. So one complicated problem I will discuss in continuation of my lecture. And if you remember, students, I discussed in the last class, that is the 20th lecture, that is the analysis part we did with Darcy-Weisbach equation. Today, I will just use the Hagen-Williams equation. That with that Hagen-Williams equation, we'll try to solve that network problem. Now, you see the network, again, the same principle we will see, the incoming flow should be equal to the outgoing flow. That is the, we will maintain the conservation of mass of the flow. That is the, whatever the flow incomes, outflows from the circuit network. So 6 m³/min flow is entering into the, that is the inflow in one node. That is the left top corner. And it is the outflowing, we can see 4 m³ + 1 + 1. So the summation of the inflow and the summation of the outflow should be equal. So this is the main conservation of the flow. Whatever the flow comes in, it should be flows out. Number two is the there are the three loops we can see, that is 1, 2, and 3 loop. How many pipes we can see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 pipes. So we can see the 10 pipes are there in the network system, and how many nodes are there? 8 nodes. So you see the first, the assumptions, this type of flow analysis using the Hardy-Cross method, the simulation, that is the trial method, first trial 1, trial 2, trial 3, the iteration process will be continued. Now first the assumption is the you have to just assume the flow in the pipe, and then we'll make the necessary correction to make the correct flow in the pipe. Suppose the 6 m³/min is the inflow in the top left corner we can see. Now in the pipe 1 we can subdivided in pipe 1 and 2 the 2 and 4, that means you can consider 4 m³/min is flowing into the pipe 2 and 2 m³/min is flowing into the pipe 1. And again, this is the much more complicated than the previous one which we discussed in my last class. And again, if you see that 2 through pipe 1, again it is subdivided in pipe 4 and pipe 5 in 0.2 and 1.8. So 0.2 and 1.8. Now I must tell you the logic for the assumption of the flow. What are the logic that the assumption of the flow? Because you can see the 40 cm dia pipe, that is the pipe 2 mark. Definitely that will carry much more flow than the 25 cm pipe dia, because more the dia, flow will be more. So we have considered the 4 m³ in the pipe 2, marked pipe 2, and 2 m³ in the pipe marked 1, because there the dia is less. Again, when if we continue in the flow in the pipe 1, that is the 25 cm dia in the network system, which you can, from which we can see the downward flow, if you see the 2 m³, then it will be subdivided into 0.2 in the 15 cm dia and 20 cm dia 1.8. So consideration of the more flow in the more dia compared to the less dia, that is the thumb rule, that is the assumption logic, that more dia you have to assume the more flow, and then you will adjust the correction, which will be found out using the equation of the Hagen-Williams, that we'll see. Now, continuing the flow in the pipe marked 5, 1.8, can see the outflow is 1. That means balance 0.8 will flow into the pipe 7. Fine. Up to this it is clear. Next, again, you see the pipe 4 continuing flow is 0.2, because that 2 is divided in 1.8 and 0.2 between the 5 number pipe and 4 number pipe. Now, in the pipe 4, that 0.2 flow is continuing rightward, and again it will continue downward in the pipe 6. Why I am continuing 0.2? Because 0.2 flow in the pipe mark 6 and 0.8 flow in the pipe mark 7, it will sum up and it will come, it will be emerged as outflow in the node point right bottom corner 1 meter cube per minute. That is 0.8 plus 0.2 is 1 meter cube. So the flow balance is there. So the flow balance has to be there. This is the fundamental first step. We have to consider the trial. The flow balance you have to make. So the loop 2 we have completed. Loop 1 is partially completed, because in the pipe 2, which you can see that 4 meter cube per second, 4 meter cube per minute flow is there. Then it is subdivided in 3.6 in the pipe 8 and 4.4 in pipe 3. Why 3.6 in pipe 8? Because pipe 8 30 centimeter da and pipe 3 is 15 centimeter da. So pipe 8 is double the diameter of pipe 3. So definitely pipe 8 will carry much flow. So you have considered more flow in 3.6 and less flow in 0.4, that is in pipe number 3. Now this 0.4 meter cube per minute, which is flowing in pipe 3, it is continuing in pipe 10.4, and again it will continue in pipe 9.4, because that 3.6 in pipe 8 and 0.4, that is the flow in pipe 9 and pipe 10, and summing up that 2 flow will emerge as 4 meter cube per minute from the top right corner node. So the mass balance is there, and the total loop 1, loop 2, loop 3, the assumption flow considering the mass balance of the flow has been prepared. Now we are going for the tabular form. What tabular form that we have to make? That tabular form means because it will be a trial error method. So you see the 4 numbers trials has been done. Very interesting. There are trial 1, trial 2, trial 3, trial 4. Generally, the iteration process 4 to 5 maximum to get the exact value of the flow. So here you see the table 1 consists of the trial 1 and trial 2. And then next table is trial 3 and trial 4. And trial 4, I have ended that calculation. Now, the interesting thing is that, first of all, the format of the tabular form, first of all, we will be applying your Hagen-Williams equation to solving this problem. Some type of different approach I am just showing you, different from the previous lecture, which when you have used the Darcy-Weisbach equation. Now, first is the loop, first column, second column is pipe marked, third column is K1, that is the K coefficient. We know the formula of the Hagen-Williams equation is K U to the power 1.85. Again, I am just showing you the formula. If you remember that day, I have described n equal to 1.85. What is this formula? This is the basic formula, that is the k q to the power n, and n is 1.85. This is the fundamental Hagen-Williams formula, where HF is the head loss. So head loss is given by k q to the power n, because in loop, the summation of the head loss, the summation of the head loss is 0. So from that fundamental thing, we'll find out the summation of the head loss, in terms of the equation of the Hagen-Williams equation, that we'll find out. Now, first of all, K constant, K, what is the K? K, we have already In the earlier lecture, we have seen that how to calculate the k, because it is k is nothing but it depends on the L and D. You see the earlier lecture, then you can find out what is k expression. I can show you again. What is k? Just I am showing you. You see the k is basically the 8FL. It is the dark now Hegel-Ulam, what the Hegel-Ulam equations are? Yes, fine. KL cube whole to the power 1.85. That is what is K? K is depending on L, D, and C. So L is known to you, D is known to you, C the Hegel-Ulam constant is known. So definitely the K is known to you, because once the K is known, once the L and D are given, then it depends on the L and D that you have seen. So K can be found out corresponding the K value of each pipe. K first you have to find out, this is the initial step. First you have to find out the K in that equation, which is given by KE into Q to the power N. Now just you see the loop 1, because we are now concentrating the loop 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 number pipes are there. So first flow, the direction you just first here. Some type of different conception I just want to bring. Earlier I have shown you the problem anti-clockwise positive and clockwise negative. So there is no restriction. In this case, I will show you the clockwise positive and anti-clockwise is negative. Because if one direction you can consider positive, then the and other direction is negative. That is the fundamental thing of the flow consideration. Now here you see the loop 1. You see the one number pipe, the flow is anti-clockwise, that is downward, means if you consider in the loop 1, then the two flow, that is a 2 m³/min, I mean to say, so it is anti-clockwise, so that means it is negative. So the one number pipe, it is negative flow. Negative means, and what is the value of the one number pipe K? One number pipe K is -1.93, and the flow is, you see the trial 1, that is very beginning in the assumption of the flow mass equation, that we have number 1 pipe corresponding flow is -2, as I have told you, because it is anti-clockwise. Now let us look to the pipe number 2. Let's see what is the flow. Pipe number 2, if you see the network, pipe number 2, if you see, this is the clockwise flow in the loop 1, so it is positive, so it is given by 4, so +4. So in tabular it is shown +4. Again pipe number 3, let us come to the pipe number 3, again it is +0.4, downward flow means it is clockwise, you see from the figure, so it is +0.4. So number 3 pipe is +0.4, fine. Then the remaining pipe of the left pipe, that is the 4 number pipe, what we can see, it is the anti-clockwise, because if you consider the loop 1, it is the anti-clockwise, so it is -0.2. So it is -0.2, I have marked it is -0.2. So once the one loop is first the loop, one loop, particular loop you have to complete. Then once you complete, then second loop, then third loop. So this is the concept. So one loop, first the flow plus minus, we have configured the flow. Then what is the HF value? HF value is nothing but the famous Hegel-Ulam equation, what says K Q to the power 1.85. That is the formula. That means for pipe number 1, what will be the HF? The calculation is 0.93. into -2 to the power 1.85, so it will be -3.35. again pipe number 2, 0.188, that is K, into Q to the power N, that means 4 whole to the power 1.85, so it will be given as 2.44. likewise 3 pipe and 4 pipe, we have calculated the HF. Once you have find out HF, then HF by Q will be found out, because this type of calculation will be very much convenient to do in the Excel sheet, because the Excel sheet are the formulation sheet, and this calculation can be done easily. So just column, one column you select HF, then you divide by the Q column, you will get the all the figure at a time. So these type of computation generally done in Excel sheet programming. So HF by Q we can calculate, so simply just dividing HF by Q. Now what is NHF by Q? In sigma HF by Q, because the sigma HF by Q means for a particular loop, you just add sigma HF by Q means 1.68 plus 0.61 plus 5.15 plus 5.7, all you sum up, and this is called sigma HF by Q, and then you multiply with 1.85 and you will get 24.31. So this is I am telling you that sigma HF by Q is found out that 24.31. What is sigma HF? Sigma HF is algebraically sum, that means minus plus plus minus. So taking consideration of the plus minus, net sum is plus 0.0.01. So up to this it is clear that sigma N sigma HF by Q we have found out for a loop is 1, for a loop 1, then N sigma HF by then sigma HF calculated. And then finally, the target is we have to calculate the correction flow, that is the delta Q, which is to be corrected. So how the delta, what is the delta Q formula? Let us see the formula delta Q, that applying the Heisenberg equation, what is the delta Q formula that I am going to tell you. So this equation is applied, delta Q is sigma HF by N sigma HF by Q. So simply you divide sigma HF by N sigma HF by Q delta Q. That means sigma HF, that means if you see the, loop 1, then sigma HF is 0.01. So 0.01 divided by N sigma HF by Q, that means 24.31. So you see all are zero. But a very interesting thing you must observe, that in pipe 9, pipe number 3 and pipe number 4, instead of 0, because 0.01 divided by 24.31 is nothing but 0, you will not get any integer value. So pipe 1, pipe 2, 0 it is seen. But it is very much interesting to note that pipe 9, pipe 3 and pipe 4, instead of 0, it has come some value, which is 0.24 and 0.34. Why? Because this is the thing, this is the mystery of the analysis, that I must say you that pipe 3 and pipe 4 are the common pipe loop of the loop 2 and loop 3. Pipe 3, you see the common pipe between the loop 1 and loop 3, and the pipe 4 is a common pipe of the loop 1 and loop 2. So for this common type of pipe, unless and until the other loop calculation are there, so that pipe delta Q cannot be obtained. So obviously, if you see the from pipe 3, pipe 4, from loop 1 consideration, the correction will be 0, but that correction cannot be put in this corresponding pipe 3 and 4 because it is attached with the other loop. So unless and until other loop correction is there, so that correction cannot be put. So what we have come to conclusion, that let us see point 3. Let us see the pipe number 4. Pipe number 4 is common pipe of loop 1. Pipe number 4 is common pipe of loop 1 and loop 2. So now we can concentrate on loop 2, and there the correction will be found out, that will be taken in correct pipe number 4. So now loop 2, if you see what are the flow, you see the pipe number 4, it is a clockwise flow. So 0.2 is plus because the clockwise is positive. So you see the loop 2, now we have to say loop 2, pipe number 4, 0.2 is positive. Then coming to the 6 number pipe of loop 2, 6 number pipe, the downward flow means it is clockwise, so that 0.2 is again positive. So you see in the tabular form, 6 number pipe is plus 0.2 meter cube per minute. Now page number 7. Page number 7, if you see the anti-clockwise flow, because pointed we can see the anti-clockwise flow, so it will be minus pointed. So 7 number, if you see the 7 number pipe, 7 number pipe in the loop 2, it is minus pointed. And the last pipe left in the loop 2, that is the 5 number, that is pipe 5, let us discuss. It is again the downward flow, means it is anti-clockwise, so it is minus 1.8. So this is the convention. One convention you have to fix: if it is plus clockwise positive, then anti-clockwise is negative. So one direction you have to consider positive. Just like earlier lecture, we have considered anti-clockwise positive, then clockwise negative. Now just we are going in reverse. So you have to stick one principle. So the plus minus, plus minus flow is considered. Then the same process will be, I'm just reiterating the same process which you have followed in loop 1, the HF. You have found out K into Q whole to the power 1.85, and you have found out that HF corresponding to the pipe of 4675. And the HF by Q, simply divided by HF by Q also you have got. Now again, summation of HF by Q, then multiply 1.85 will give 27.51. And if you, what is the delta Q? Delta Q is the HF, sigma HF by N, sigma HF by Q. What is the sigma HF? Sigma HF is algebraic sum, that is plus consideration of the plus and minus, the net figure is minus 9.47. So if you divide by 9.87 by 27.51, you will get 0.34, 0.34, 0.34, 0.34, 4675. Now if you remember the 4 number pipe, as I told you, it is a common pipe of the loop 1 and loop 2. So this 0.34, that means if it is in 0.34, then in other loop it will be minus 0.34, because the one common pipe for a particular loop, if it is positive, then it has to be negative in the other direction of the other loop. Say for example, I am just showing you 4 number pipe, it is 0.2 flow, which is seen is positive, that is the anticlockwise flow for loop 1, but it is clockwise in the loop 2. So in one loop, if it is positive, then other loop it should be negative. So that is the principle we have done here. So if it is plus 0.34, then it has to be minus 0.34. Likewise, we are calculating the loop 2, loop 3 in the same process. Let us see the loop 3, the pipe, one of the pipes, suppose the trial 1, the loop 3, 3, 8, 9, 10, pipe number. Fine. So if you see the diagram, 3, that means 3 is the anti-clockwise flow. So anti-clockwise means negative. So what is the flow? 0.4. So minus 0.4. You see the minus 0.4. Again, for pipe number 8, if you see the flow is 3.6 meter cube per minute. So this is clockwise, so plus 3.6. So it is plus 3.6. Fine. Now let us look pipe number 9. What is pipe number 9? 0.4, it is anti-clockwise, and same pipe number 10, 0.4, it is also anti-clockwise, so both are negative. So 9, 10, both are negative, minus 0.4. So you see the minus, both are minus 0.4. Again, the same process which you have followed in the loop 1 and loop 2, the HF head loss, just applying the Hegelian equation, KQ to the power N, that is K into Q to the power 1.85. So corresponding HF value will be obtained. And once the HF value will be obtained, HF divided by Q, HF by Q also obtained, summation of the HF by Q, then multiply with N, that is 1.85, will give the value of 19.78, which is the denominator factor of the correction, that is the delta Q. Delta Q formula is delta HF by NHF by Q, what you have seen. Now what is sigma HF? Sigma HF is the algebraic sum of the head loss of that loop. So it is given by minus net figure is plus 4.69. Now what is delta Q? Delta Q is nothing but sigma HF by N sigma HF by Q. That means 4.69 divided by 19.78. And if you see, the correction is coming minus 0.24. So why the correction is coming minus 0.24? Because the delta HF by delta N HF delta Q is plus. So it will be correction will be, the error is this, the opposite of the error is correction, so minus. Just like loop 2, the error is minus 9.47 divided by 27.51. So before that one sign will be there, minus minus plus, so plus 0.34. So here it is, actually the formula is minus HF sigma HF divided by N sigma HF by Q. Let us look about the formula, then it will be understood. The formula is, yes, as I told you, delta Q is minus sigma HF by N sigma HF by Q. So minus minus plus. So all the corrections are coming as plus 0.03. But one correction is coming as 0.04. Why this thing is happening? Again, I am going to say that 3, that is the pipe number 3, is a common pipe. Very interesting thing. This is a common pipe. If you see the loop, pipe number 3 is a common pipe between the loop 1 and 2, a loop 1 and 3. Again, I am telling, pipe number 3 is a common pipe between the loop 1 and 3. So, since it is a common pipe between loop 1 and 3, so from 3, the error is 0.03. And for 1, the error is 0.01. So, summation of 0.01 plus 0.03 is 0.04. So, that's why if the pipe 3 only 0.04, but other pipe 8, 9, 10, since these are not the common pipe, so they are the error is 0.03. So you have to take care which is the common pipe of the common loop. So that pipe, the both loops correction has to be algebraically added, and that has to be taken care, which have been shown. Now, once the correction delta Q is there found, you see the trial to the next table, because I will just show you the trial to, then after that the same iteration process has been continued in trial 3 and trial 4, because the process is same. Now you see, just a minute, I'm just showing you. Yes, suppose if I consider the pipe 1 in loop 1, what was the assumption flow? What was the assumption flow? Assumption flow was in trial 1, the assumption flow was minus 2. And what is the correction? Correction was 0, no correction was there. That means you have correctly assumed the flow, no correction was there, that means no error is found. So minus 2 still in trial 2 also, the flow in the pipe is minus 2, as you can see very well from trial 2 also. Now let us see the pipe 2. What assumption? In the assumption we have considered the plus 4, the correction is 0, so plus 4 flow again considered in trial 2 because there is no correction. If you see that pipe number 3 in the loop 1, that is plus 0.4, and the correction was plus 0.24. So if you add these two things, plus 4 plus 0.24, that means the new flow which is to be considered in pipe 3 in trial 2 will be plus 0.64. So this flow has been corrected as plus 0.64 in trial 2. Again, pipe number 4, that is the loop 1. So assumption was minus 0.2 and correction was minus 0.34. So minus 0.2, minus 0.34, the corrected flow considered in trial 2 in pipe number 4 is minus 0.54. So this is the thing. This is the thing I am going to highlight again. Just trial 2 versus trial 1, if you see, then loop 1 I have described. Again, loop 2, if you consider pipe 4, then what is the flow considered in pipe flow? Plus 0.2. What was the correction? 0.34. So in the trial 2 assumption, it has been corrected as 0.54. Next, if we talk that pipe number 6 in pipe loop number 2, then the assumed flow was 0.2, correction was 0.34, so corrected flow 0.54. Now you see the seven number pipe in loop 2, that is assumption was minus 0.8 and the correction was plus 0.34. That means minus 0.8 plus 0.34. So how much corrected flow will be there? Minus 0.46. And the last pipe in the loop 2, that is the pipe number 5, minus 1.8 was there and plus 0.34 was correction found in the trial 1. So minus 0.8 plus 0.34, so minus 1.46, the corrected flow has been obtained. So this is the thing. Second trial, now the third loop also, likewise the different flow of pipe number 3, 8, 9, 10 has been found as minus 0.64 plus 3.36, minus 0.64, minus 0.64. The process is same. Whatever the process you have followed trial 1, that same process will be continued in trial 2. Same HF you have to find out by Hagen-William equation, then HF by Q, then N sigma HF by Q, and you find out the sigma HF, and finally the delta Q, that is the minus delta C, minus sigma HF by N sigma HF by Q. So this is a rigorous process. So nowadays programming has been obtained. So if you run the programming, inputting the data, automatic the programming output will be found out, but you have to know the Hardy-Cross method, the analytic part by hand calculation. You have to know applying this Hagen-William equation and that Darcy-Weisbach formula. So you see the correction gradually is becoming decreasing, and after fourth trial there is hardly change in the flow. So we can say that the trial number 4 can be ended because no change further is obtained, we have seen in the formula. So this is the I will close it a day, and I will just conclude the at least the Hardy-Cross method, the analytical part of the pipe distribution network, that I will complete, because this is a trial error method simulation process. You must know the conception, the flow mass balance equation, the head loss of the particular loop, the sign convention, the common pipe flow between the loop. That has been highlighted. So I'll upload my lecture numerical problem solutions in the Google Classroom. Kindly go through that and practice on. And there has to be make practice, hand-on practice for that calculation. Otherwise, in exam there will be a problem in error in calculation. So kindly go through the practice. At least 1, 2, 3 trial. You go on practicing this type of problem, and I will give another problem as your assignment, as your home tutorial. First you go through my lectures, and hopefully we will be meeting in the online June class for one-to-one interaction for further clarification if any doubts you have in this analytical portion of the pipe distribution network. So thank you all. So have a nice day.